Any Muslim can tell me why? Hello? Hello?
I'm calling you, you're not answering.
Ah, you are calling me, I'm not answering. My friend, I am on air and everybody will hear you if you call me. You never call me yet. Anyway, what do you like to say? Go ahead. Everybody can hear you now.
Hello?
I hear you. Go ahead.
Yeah, is this Christian Prince?
Yes, it is me, my friend. How I can help you?
Okay, I would like to ask you politely. Mm-hmm. Now, if you would like to discuss any subject or any topic, if you want to be professional, you should, first of all, not you don't have to jump from a subject to a subject and a topic to a topic. Mm-hmm. And you don't give people a chance to discuss whatever you want to discuss or throw suspicions. So you don't give the chance for the other Muslims or the Muslims who are here and listening, and you are mocking their religion and their prophet, and you are mocking even Allah himself. Mm-hmm. So to be fair, first of all, you should tell us if you are a believer, a Christian believer, then we can talk to each other. If you are atheist, because a Christian believer cannot mock Allah, right or wrong,
My friend, first of all, I'm a Christian. Secondly, I'm not mocking Allah. Allah, he mocked himself.
Allah mocked himself?
Yes, as an example, in front of us, it says, do you see that we don't want to change the topic? You call me in the perfect time. It says that you asked me a question, my friend, let us not change the topic. You asked me a question, let me answer you, please. You are the one who put the rule. I'm going to respect the rules you put. Allah, he mocked himself when he said that the prophet continued for such and such period of time, imagining that he had sex with his wife, but in fact he did not. Is that a mocking for Allah and his prophet or not?
No. One second. Now, you are saying that we, in our Quran, have mocked Allah because you are saying or claiming that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he came up with this Quran. Now, this is something else.
Don't change the topic. No. Don't change the topic. I gave you an example. Okay. Don't go out of the example, please.
Yeah. I'm just following up the point here with you. So, we have to be on one base. Mm-hmm. If you are a believer or you are a Christian believer and you are not going to mock Allah, your point of view, it's okay. We can discuss that. Now, if you're going to say that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is mocking Allah with the ayat that he came up with,
my friend, you know exactly, so you know exactly who is a Christian prince, and you are the one who's calling me, and now you are putting me conditions if you want to talk to me. Why are you calling me if you are putting conditions to talk to me? I'm giving you time to talk, and you asked me a question, I gave you an answer. I said, what kind of Allah and what kind of a prophet he mocked himself to the point he says that he have a prophet was under the black magic to the point controlled by the shaitan, because the black shaitan, the black magic is the mid of the work of shaitan, and his a prophet is under the control of shaitan to the point he imagine himself having sex. Isn't it you Muslims who are mocking your prophet and mocking Allah? Answer me, please.
Okay, so now the mocking point is that how can a prophet get black magic by a magician or a Jewish magician?
It's not only that, it is more than this. The black magic, it is the prophet, he is under the black magic controlled by the devil. It is the prophet, his reputation is being ruined.
No, he was not controlled by devil, prince. He was sick, and this is a proof.
Is magic sickness?
He was physically sick, my friend.
I'm asking you, is magic sick?
Listen, Prince. Okay, I'm going to answer you. You're not giving me the chance.
Go ahead.
Give me 30 seconds, okay?
Go ahead.
Now, you're saying that he was throwing ayat and coming up with ayat under the black magic. How come a prophet comes with an ayat if he is drugged or he's let's say, under black magic or he's hallucinating or whatever? This is not possible, okay? Now, you can get sick. Now, first of all, do you believe in magic? This is question number one. In Christianity, do you believe in magic?
No, we don't.
No, you do.
No, we don't.
No, you do.
No, we don't.
No, you do.
Prove it.
No, are you Catholic or a Protestant?
My friend, we have a Bible. We have the Bible. It doesn't say that we believe in magic. Actually, the Bible speaks about magic, that when Moses, he did do his miracle in front of the Pharaoh, his magic overcome their magic because they are magician, which means the miracle of God overcome the tricks of the false people.
So the prophets are magicians.
They are not. We don't believe. For us, you see, if you want to understand my belief, You take it from me, yeah, how what we believe, not okay, you. If I want to show you what the Quran says, listen. Yes, if I want to show you a Quran verse, I will show you the interpretation of the verse according to Islam, not according to me. Do you agree with that?
No, we do agree with that.
Now, okay, I'm showing you now. I'm showing you the interpretation. I'm showing you the interpretation according to Christianity. It's not up to you to tell me it does not mean that. So now let us focus on the topic. You're a prophet, and that the black magic is the black magic from the devil. Yes or not?
He was under the black magic, and that proves that he's a human being, and that proves that he can get sick, and that proves that he can die.
All right.
Okay? So he was not throwing ayat prince because he was under black magic. So if
you
are from a drug person,
hold on. So now you admit that the prophet was under black magic, but isn't the prophet?
Listen to me, prince. Don't put words in my mouth. He was affected. The symptoms of a black magic
affected. What does that mean? What does that mean?
The symptoms, getting weak, getting headache.
My friend, what headache? The guy, he imagined himself doing things he did not do.
Don't say the guy. Listen to me. No, Prince, please have respect. If we are going,
is he a god or is a guy? Is he a god? Is he a god for you or he's a guy? Listen. Don't tell me what to say. If you want to talk to me, you are welcome. You want to leave, you can leave. He is a guy. He is no one for me. He is a prophet for you. It's up to you. Now answer. Is this guy Muhammad? Is he? I don't respect your prophet. Listen carefully. I don't respect your prophet, and you know that. We don't respect someone. He killed us. We don't respect a rapist. We don't respect a child molester. Listen.
You have.
Listen. You are trying. You are trying to run away from the topic. You're a prophet saying the hadith says he was bewitched, my friend. The hadith says he was bewitched. What do you mean he was sick? What do you mean he was sick? He was bewitched. I don't respect your prophet. You like it. You don't like it. Go fly. I don't respect your prophet. I will never respect such a man. So answer now. Don't make an excuse to run away from the topic. You got busted. You're a prophet and imagine himself having sex. Is that under the black magic or not?
You cannot debate. If you cannot be polite.
You are not answering. Excuse is not being polite. What polite from you? I have to say Muhammad was a good guy. I can't even say the word guy for you. I cannot say guys. I cannot shut up. Imagine guys. I cannot say the word guy. Is that an insult? I said this guy. This is an insult. Muhammad is not a guy no more. He's God. Those Abdul, they worship him. I cannot say the word guy. So what I can say? The word guy, the same as I say this man. He's not a guy. So what he is? What is your prophet? He's a guy or he's a girl? Is your prophet a guy or he's a girl? Answer me.
He's not a prophet. I'll respect your point of view.
Is he a guy or a girl? Is he a guy or a girl? I'm asking you. Is your prophet a guy or a girl?
It's a freaking street language, my friend.
My friend, is Isa a guy or not?
Is Isa
the one in the Quran? Is he a guy or a girl?
Don't go and curve.
Now don't change the topic. Answer. You are hiding behind excuses. Obviously, you don't want to talk about it. You don't want to answer. What kind of a prophet? What kind of a prophet? He is a prophet of God. He is a prophet of God. And yet he is under the black magic of the devil. Answer me.
You don't have a respect for a prophet, and you say Isa is a guy.
Yeah, Isa is a guy. He is not my prophet. I don't know who's Isa. Who is Isa? No. Don't tell me Isa is a prophet. Who is Isa? What is his last name?
Isa is a man.
What is his last name?
A guy. You cannot
Abdul, don't change the topic. You see, here we go, guys. Here we go. Those Muslims, they never answer a question. Isa, you said Isa, right? Isa, who is Isa? Introduce Isa to me. Who is Isa? Who is Isa?
Allah, Isa is a prophet. And
I don't care. This is not a question. I'm not asking you for his job. I'm asking you, who is Isa? Can you give me his full name?
What do you mean, who is Isa?
Who is Isa? Look, I want to know who's Isa. You told me there's a guy, his name is Isa. Who's Isa?
The original Christian's prophet, not your prophet.
My friend, this is not a question. Don't tell me who is the original. Don't tell me who is the clone. I'm asking you, who is Isa? You said to me there's a guy, his name is Isa. Isa who?
Who's Isa? I'll tell you who is Isa. Isa. You tell me his grandfather's names and his mother's grandfather's
names. Give me the names.
I'll get you the tree.
Here we go. Okay, give me the names. I'm asking you, why you don't give me the names? What is Isa's name? What is Isa's name?
Prince, don't ask me stupid questions.
No, I'm asking you a stupid question. You cannot answer even the stupid one. This is how weak you are. I'm asking you, who is Isa? You cannot answer. Isa, the son of who? Who is Isa? What his family? What his last name? Answer me, please. Answer me. This is my question. Are you going to tell me what to ask? This is my question. I mean, this question is important for me. Listen. I am not smart like you. This is an important question for me. You are a smart person. Please speak to me. Maybe I'm silly. Answer my question. Isa, the son of who? I want to know. Who is Isa?
Moses, the son of who? This is my answer to you.
Oh, no problem. I will answer you. But first you answer my question. First you answer my question. Don't jump to ask me a question about Musa, son of who. I will tell you the son of who. Hey. Don't run away. Isa is the son of who? What his family name? What is his family name? What is the family?
Al-Imran. Listen.
Thank you. Shut up. Guys, did he say Umran? Don't talk. You are in mute now. I got you busted. Finally, he answer. What is the last name of Jesus? Is Umran. Who is Umran? Umran is the father of Mary. The mic is yours. Do you agree with that? Umran is the father of Mary? Yes or no? Do you agree that Umran is the father of Mary?
Nobody can hear me now?
No, they hear you. Is Umran the father of Mary?
Listen, you silly.
Is Umran the father of Mary? Yes or no?
And it's a miracle.
I'm not talking about the miracle right now. Don't talk about miracles. I'm asking you, is Umran the father of Mary? Yes or no?
What?
Is Umran the father of Mary? Yes or no?
Do you have a piece of frag behind?
My friend, yes, I have a frag. Do you want me to show you a hate about the frag? Don't go there. Now answer. Is Umran the father of Mary? What's wrong with you? Why I need to repeat the question 1,000 times so to make you answer it? Who's Umran? You said Umran. You said his grandfather is Umran. Who's Umran? Is he the father of Mary?
He's not Umran. He's not Arabic. You don't speak properly.
Okay, so what the name? Guys, it's not Umran. So it is what? It's what?
Imran.
Okay, Imran. So Imran, guys, it's Imran, not Umran. Imran is the father of Mary, yes or no?
I don't believe this, wallah. I don't. You're so.
Answer me, Abdul. Are you out of battery? Why you don't answer? Is Imran the father of Mary? You said Imran, not Umran. Let me sing it for you. Hold on. Imran, who are you? Ya Imran. So I'm asking you, is Imran the father of Mary? Either you say yes or you say no.
I'm singing.
Singing is halal in Christianity, is not Islam. Your prophet, he said, singing is haram. Answer me. Why you are a coward? Why you don't want to answer? Is Imran the father of Mary? Either you say yes or you say no. Very simple.
What's important in that?
It's important for me. It's important. Everybody will see in a few seconds how important it is. I'm asking you, is Imran the father of Mary or the... Imran, who's Imran? I'm asking you, who's Imran? Is he the father of Mary? The mother of Jesus? Is he Abdul? I want an answer. You see, I have my experience with Muslims. They are like goats. They keep chewing, but they eat nothing, and they give nothing, and they do nothing. It is Ramadan. You eat and you sleep. You snore. Don't go and sleep in my lap. I want an answer. Who is Imran? Is Imran the father of Mary? Yes or no?
Can you do that?
I cannot stop unless you answer me. Is Imran the father of Mary? Why you don't want to answer?
You put your stinky snake.
Why you don't want to answer? Stinky Abdul, you are the one who take a shower in Bi'ri Bida'a like your prophet. Bi'ri Bida'a, where dogs, they sleep, they the dogs, women blood from period. Don't talk about stink. Now answer, is Imran the father of Mary? Yes or no? Shut up, you idiot. Guys, why he don't want to answer? Can somebody tell me why? Can anyone in the world can tell me why they want to tell me? I mean, what is difficult about it? Who is Imran? Is he the father of Mary? Either you say he is or you say he's not. Very simple. So Abdul, for the last time, otherwise I'm going to block you and get lost. I have no time for kids. Is Imran?
You're mocking.
Is Imran is the father of Mary? Yes or no? Is Imran the father of Mary? Yes or no? Coward, coward, coward. Coward. Is Imran the father of Mary? Why you are scared to answer? What the point? Why you are scared? Explain. Why? Then answer. Who is Imran? Is he the father of Mary? Is he?
Okay, he's the father. Okay.
Thank you. Shut up. Shut up. Hold on. I will give you the mic when I finish, please. So we can. Guys, did you hear him saying he is the father of Mary? People in the room, people in the chat, the 300 people listening, did you hear him saying he is the father of Mary? Oh, boy. Oh boy. And the Imran is the father of Moses. So the Quran teach that Mary, the mother of Jesus, is the sister of Aaron, the daughter of Amram, which is the father of Moses and Aaron. Now, do you know why I made you answer? Because simply, your Quran made by a false prophet and false God. In chapter 19, verse number 28, it says, Ya Ukhta Harun, O sister of Aaron, who is the one they are speaking to? Mary, the daughter of Amran. But Amran is the father of Aaron. How you explain to us such a stupid mistake in the Quran? The mic is yours and I'm listening.
To answer that question, am I a historian? Do the prophet's parents?
You are a historian now. You are not historian. You need to be a historian now. I don't care, my friend, if you are a historian. You are a Muslim and a one who said to me, you want to challenge me and you want to debate me. So what kind of a prophet he made such a stupid mistake? Listen, you see, I'm giving you the time to answer. Look, guys. He asked me for time to answer. When I asked him a question, he said, what, I am a historian now? So what are you? What are you? You are not a historian. So what are you? I'm asking you to answer the question. I don't care if you are a historian or not. This is your religion.
I'm a Muslim. I'm a normal Muslim.
You are normal? You are normal? Are you sure you are normal?
Yes.
No, as long you are a normal Muslim, as long you are a normal Muslim, can you give me a normal question? Can you give me a normal question, please? The question is, what kind of a prophet he made such a mistake? He says that Mary, the daughter of Amran, and you are the one who gave me the name. You said, yes, she is the daughter of Amran, but Amran is the father of Aaron. Hello?
Not an historian. I don't care who is the father of Mary or who is the grandfather of Mary. Go back for square one. What was your question about our prophet?
Guys, you don't care. Have you ever heard of, a debate like this? I don't care. You just got busted. So you don't care if your prophet making a mistake? You don't care. You don't care if you, are you saying that you notice now that your prophet is lying and you don't care?
I'm not expert in your religion.
I don't listen. You just admitted that your prophet, he made a big stupid mistake and you don't care. This is what you are saying to me.
No, I didn't say that.
You said you don't care.
No, I told you that the Prophet ﷺ, he was sick from the black magic.
This is why this is a sick guy is talking, guys. This is why he misquoted the name. He have the wrong name, but the one is talking there is the Quran, my friend. Listen, Abdul, Allah was and the black magic too, because this is Quran. The one is saying that Allah is the Quran, not Muhammad. Are you saying Muhammad is Allah? Are you saying Muhammad is Allah?
No, Muhammad is Allah.
So what do you mean Muhammad was sick? What does this have to do with Muhammad being sick? What does this have to do with Muhammad being sick? Why Allah is quoting the wrong name for the father of Mary? He think that Mary is the sister of Aaron and her father is Imran.
If Muhammad can get sick from black magic, why Allah is sacrificing and killing
another
prophet
question? This is not, don't change the topic. No. Why Allah made a mistake? Why Allah is sick? The sick Allah. You are saying to me Allah is sick because now you're saying to me that Muhammad he got the wrong name because he was sick. But the fact the one is talking is Allah.
Answer this question, you stupid prince. Answer this question.
About what? About testicles? About what?
Sacrifice for his children. You are a child. You are a sinner. You know. How come a God?
Okay. Hold on. God. So guys, now the family. Hold on. Let me mute you, guys. He decided to jump, speak out of the topic because he got busted. So do you admit that your prophet he made a stupid mistake and he is a false prophet? So we can move to the second topic, which is about sacrificing. Are you willing to do that? Are you willing to say to admit that this is a mistake in the Quran? So I can answer about your question about sacrificing.
It's no mistakes in Quran, like you're
you just admitted. You just admitted. You just said I don't care. You just admitted. You just told me that Mary, her father, is Imran. You just admitted that Mary, father, is Imran. Everybody heard you. This is why I insist you to answer. It took me 20 minutes to make you answer the question. So now we have a stupid God. His name is Allah. Stupid prophet. His name is Muhammad. Saying that there is a guy. His name is Imran. He is the father of Mary, and he is the father of Aaron. How Aaron and Mary, they have the same father. Can you explain to us?
Give me 15 seconds. If you are fair enough,
I will give you 15 minutes, but don't change the topic. Go ahead.
I can make you a Muslim, inshallah, with the power.
Inshallah, brother. Start.
I can convince you. Fast.
Oh, no problem. Okay, answer me about the mistake in the Quran about Mary. Her father is Imran. How this happened? Go ahead.
If you are seeking the truth,
don't change the topic. I don't talk about the truth. You don't have any. Now answer. What kind of God he make a mistake about Imran? How Imran became the father of Mary and the father of Aaron? How this happened?
What about this deal? What about this deal?
We can talk about Disneyland later.
If you will convince
What Disney? Abdul, I'm asking you a question. Don't change the topic. How Allah he made such a mistake? He is God. And yet he think that Mary is the sister of Aaron and her father, his name is Imran. How this happened?
I'm telling you.
Okay, I'm listening.
We can debate and we can fix points to discuss it. I can be ready. I can do my homework. You can do your homework.
Oh, so you are ready now? You are saying you are not ready now? You are not ready?
No. I was just wondering. And I will show you. No, of course.
You are wondering. I wonder how. I wonder why you told me about the blue sky and all what I can see. Just a Abdul jumping around me. I thought it's a guy. It turned monkey and all what I can see a monkey around me. What are you talking about? So you are calling me to debate me and you are saying to me you need to do homework now?
Debating you about my religion, not about your religion.
I'm talking about your religion. The Quran saying that Mary is the daughter of Imran, the sister of Aaron. This is your religion, my friend. So now answer me. Don't tell me I'm not ready. All you Muslims are not ready. I never saw a Muslim is ready to debate me. Never.
Okay. What is your question? Make it short.
Guys, now he's asking me the question. You believe it? I mean, after 30 minutes, I'm repeating the question. He's asking me what is the question?
The black magic, and now
you are the one who mentioned Musa, you are the one who mentioned Isa. Listen. My question is very simple. Let me repeat that question. Hold on.
I don't care.
You don't care?
It's not important for me.
It's important for me. It's important for me. It's a mistake. What is that?
Ask you.
Abdul, what do you mean it's not important for you? What do you mean? Who are you to say is not important? Are you making fun of the word of Allah? Are you saying the word of Allah is not important?
Allah, you are stupid. You're so stupid and so silly.
Are you saying that the word of Allah is not important?
No, I'm not saying that.
So why are you saying it's not important for me?
I'm saying that I'm a normal person who learns from my mistakes.
You are normal. You're normal. Hold on. I need to study this. Guys, this is the first time I met a normal person, to be honest with you. My friend, I am honored. I'm truly honored to meet a normal person. I never saw a normal Muslim. Are you serious saying that you are a normal Muslim? I never met one. What do you mean you are a normal Muslim? What does that mean?
That means I'm wahid. I believe in one God, and that God has no son.
You believe in a God. He said that Mary, yes, she have a father. His name is Umran, and she is the sister of Aaron. And Umran is the father of Aaron too. How this happened?
If you are quoting this true, I believe in that. Yes.
But this is a mistake, my friend.
Whose mistake? My mistake? I'm a human being. It's okay. It's acceptable. Humans do mistakes.
But Allah is one saying that, my friend. Allah. You admit that this is a mistake. Okay. You admitted that this is a mistake, but this is a mistake of Allah. How Allah is a human being? Allah is a human being.
No. Quran is true. Quran is true.
But it's just a mistake. You just said it's a mistake. You agreed it's a mistake.
If it's mentioned in Quran and I didn't do my homework and I didn't study it because I do business in oil and trading and I don't read Quran every day, so I do mistakes as a human being, as a normal Muslim.
Okay, how Allah make a mistake now? How Allah, we are talking about the mistake of Allah. I don't care about your mistake. This is your business. How Allah makes a mistake that Mary, she is the sister of Aaron and her father is Amran, which is the father of Aaron. How this happened?
The name of Aaron.
Harun. How Mary she became the sister of Aaron and her father is Umran, which is the same father of Aaron and Musa. How this happened?
You mean that Harun is the uncle of Mary?
No, he is her brother. According to the Quran, he is her brother.
Read it properly.
My friend, it's in front of you. What's wrong with you? In chapter 19, verse number 28, it says that Aaron, Mary, the sister of Aaron. This is the Quran. And I am the one who asked you, and everybody is my witness. What is the name of the father of Mary? You said Umran. And you corrected me, supposedly saying Imran, not Umran. Huh? Christian Prince, okay. Stupid. Christian Prince, what's wrong with you? It's Imran. You remember? Imran. So now how Imran, the father of Aaron, became the father of Mary? And how Aaron and Mary became brothers and sisters?
Yeah, but how do you prove that Aaron, you who just is Harun did. In Arabic, you is just... a brother of Musa? What's your proof? Is the same Harun. Maybe it's a different Harun. Why do you say that it's the same Harun?
This is different Harun, guys. The Quran speak about one Harun. Do you have other Harun in the Quran? Can you prove to me that this is the different? Can you show me one reference, one Islamic interpretation saying that this is not the same Aaron?
The same? No, you tell me. I'm asking you this question.
Well, according to you Muslims, this is Harun, the brother of Musa, and the son of Umran.
Quote where? Says whom?
Says who? The Quran.
Where? Which ayah?
In many ayahs, as an example, if we go right now, chapter two, verse number 248.
Say the name of the surah, Prince.
I just told you. Chapter of Al-Baqarah. Maybe you don't understand the Al-Baqarah chapter. We can find the Al-Baqarah chapter for you.
Yeah.
So. Maybe I don't want to say, guys, I'm afraid to say the word, the name, then the Muslim, they will say he is not saying correctly. So I'm going to use some kind of sound effect, you know. This is the chapter name.
Hey, what's the ayah? Read it.
I just told you the chapter name.
Yeah, Surah Al-Baqarah. What's the ayah?
So now it's correct.
I don't have the Quran in front of me, Prince.
So now the cow did say it correctly, or you need to correct the cow too? I don't care. It says that the
family. Got your reference. You have done your homework.
Chapter 2, verse number 248. There's many verses, my friend. There's many verses. There's many verses. Chapter 4, verse 163. Chapter. Let me give you more. Chapter 6, verse number 48.
Read it for me.
Let us read together. Chapter 7, verse 122. Rabbu Musa wa Harun. Who is Harun and who is Musa?
Rabbu Musa wa Harun. Allah. Yani, okay.
Okay. Who is Allah, Musa and who is Harun? Who is Musa and who is Harun?
The Prophet and his brother, the Prophet.
So Harun. So Harun in the Quran is only Harun. One Harun. He is the brother of Musa.
No. No, it's not mentioned. Only Harun is the brother of Moses. Does it say that?
But you told me that.
Does it say that?
You just said that.
Oh, I didn't tell you that.
You're lying now.
You're putting words in my mouth.
I asked you, who is Harun and Musa? You said Moses is the brother of Harun.
Yeah, yeah. Listen to me, Prince.
You said that. You now, said that. Everybody heard you. Okay, let me shut you up. So, are you asking me? Are you asking me to? Are you challenging me? Hold on, hold on, hold on. Are you challenging me to show you a verse in the Quran says that Musa and Harun are brothers and they are brothers?
No, they are brothers. We know that for fact.
Okay. So what you are saying they are not then?
No, no. I'm not saying they are not brothers.
So okay, how then Harun? How Harun became the brother of? How Harun? How Harun? How Harun? What is the last name of what is the name of the father of Harun?
The name of the father of Harun? Allah, I think if Moses, if Moses, he has 12 brothers and they were all Jacob's brothers, Yaqub brothers, so it's Jacob, Yaqub.
Ooh, right? Wow! So Moses is a son of Jacob. Eesh, that's deep, my friend. Where do you get this from?
No, Musa. Musa is the son. Musa is the son. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad.
Uh-huh.
1 second. Jacob, he has 12 brothers. He has Yusuf. Then Yusuf, he has Dawood. Let me read. You need the three of the prophets. 1 second. One by one. I'll go to see in the sequence. Then Yusuf, he's the descendant of Yusuf. So Yusuf is the grandfather of Musa. So I don't know what's the name of Musa's father. No, but I know that his grandfather is. It's Jacob, Yaqub. Okay, go ahead. Then, second question.
Okay.
And they all came from Abraham, but I don't memorize the three.
They are born from Abraham. Okay, okay. All right. So,
yeah, the second question.
No. We wanna finish
you
this.
If I wanna ask me about
okay. Hold on. If we go and try to find where we can find the name or the full name of Moses, do you have a book to refer to?
The name. If you want to know if Harun, the same Harun, is your Harun, the brother of Moses,
mm-hmm.
is he the uncle of or the
no? The I mean father the father. Of, the fa- no, I, listen, the question. The question is very simple. Don't breathe. Relax. Yeah. Relax. If we need to go and find. Who is the father of Moses? Which book we should refer to find the answer?
Who's the father of Moses?
Mm-hmm. Which book we learn that from?
I have to. Which book we learn that from? It says here. 1 second. I'm quoting for you. It's Imran. Bin Qahif bin Lawi bin Yaqub alayhi salam. So I was
thank
right.
you guys. Did you hear it? Did you hear it? So Musa's his father is Imran.
Thank you. Yeah, okay.
Okay. So, and you told me, that Mary, her father is Imran too. And the Quran says that Mary is the sister of Aaron. Hold on. You agreed that Aaron and Moses are brothers, and you agreed that Musa's father, it is Imran. And you agreed that Mary's father is Imran. And the Quran says that Mary is the sister of Aaron. How Allah, he makes such a mistake. What Mary, the mother of Jesus, have to do with Imran, the father of Moses, and how Moses and Aaron, they became brothers and sisters to Mary.
You mean that, if qalat, I'm quoting for you, Surah Al-Imran, verse 35, if qalat imra'atu, Imran Rabbi, inni nadartu laka ma fi batni. Okay, the wife of Imran said, Allah, okay,
my friend, hold on.
So this is from Hannah bin Faqul.
Hold your horses.
So is your question?
Let me repeat my question, my friend. The father of Moses, according to all the Muslims, his name is Imran. The father of Mary, and you admit with that, his name is Imran. Uh-huh. Okay, so now we have Mary and Moses. Both of them, they have the same name of the same father, Imran. And the Quran confirmed. Hold on.
No. I'm correcting you now.
You said Imran. Okay. Is it the same name or not?
Yeah, it's the same name.
Thank you.
It's
okay.
The same name.
It's the same name, guys. It's the same name. But the Quran says in chapter 19, verse number 28, Surat Maryam, that Mary is the sister of Aaron.
Okay.
Sister of Aaron. Aaron is the brother of Moses, and his father is Imran. So now we have Mary and Aaron, they are brothers and sisters. and their father both as Umran. This is a mistake in the Quran.
Okay, so what do you,
so what do you mean? What do you mean? There's a long distance between Umran, it's between Mary and Musa's. How Mary she became the sister of Aaron and they have the same father.
Okay, the answer is no, we have the answer. I will answer you.
Uh-huh.
Harun, the brother of Maryam, mm-hmm. is not the same Harun as the brother of Moses.
Uh-huh.
Because Musa and Harun alone, they have a lot different in time between them and Jesus.
Uh-huh.
So it's the same Harun. So what's your point?
Okay, what is the proof that this is different Harun? What is your proof? Do you have a proof?
Okay, I'll tell you. Go for Bimbaz location website, uh-huh. and you can search it over. There's a question, and they are quoting that there is one ayah in Mary chapter,
uh-huh.
verse 28. It says, "Ya ukht Harun, ma kana abuki imra aswan, wa ma kanat umuki baghiya." Allah now is mentioning that Maryam is the sister of Aaron in this ayah. Now, the man asked again, the sheikh, he's saying, وَأَخِي هَارُونَ, saying that Moses saying, my brother Harun or Aaron, he has a stronger tongue than me, so send him with me, okay? Now, this is in chapter, I think, 55, verse 34. So, is Harun and the other Harun, are the same Harun? The sheikh replies back, no, it's not the same Harun.
Let me get your sheikh, because what you said is a lie. Your sheikh did not say that, and you can provide me a reference. Secondly, let me get you and your sheikh busted, my friend. According to the Quran. Listen. According to the Quran, Mary is the only daughter of her father.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm asking, is Mary the only daughter of her father?
Is it, this question is for me?
Yes, for you.
Well, I don't know. I didn't go through the history of Mary.
What do you mean? You just told me that she have a brother. His name is Harun.
Yes, okay. It's mentioned in the Quran. Okay.
So how she is the only child for her family, and Allah, he made a miracle because her family, they can't have a children, and now Allah, he gave them a miracle. Her name is Mary, so she have no brothers. So where Harun coming from?
Why it's a miracle? Why? Who told you that her family has only one child or one? Well, what do you mean by that? Maybe her mother was married for another person, or her father has an ex-wife or a previous wife. So,
my friend, are you a person who did read the Quran before, or you never read the Quran?
No, I did.
Okay.
I'm answering you. I'm answering you simple answers, and it's very reasonable.
Okay,
answers,
okay, friend. Okay. Hold on. If we go right now, you are not answering anything, actually. Let us go. Hold on.
It's your opinion. You say this.
I'm not saying anything.
No, it's okay. The people can judge.
Hold on.
Your followers, they can judge.
Right. Oh, your phone is ringing like crazy, man.
No, right. It's an alarm for my suhoor. I have to make suhoor now, if you don't mind. So can we fix a time to finish this?
You can call me, my friend. No problem. You can call me.
No problem. I have 1 hour left.
My friend.
Go ahead.
If I am still online, you can go and you can call me anytime. All right? No problem.
No. It's okay. We've finished this topic. It's okay. Your question that if Mary has brothers and sisters or whatsoever.
Where we can find a reference about the wife of Amran, she gave birth. What happened to the Mary? What happened to her mother? What happened exactly?
Okay, I will answer you. Mm-hmm. Is it mentioned in any Bible of the four Bibles that you have, or any written Bible scripts about the childhood of Mary, Virgin Mary,
don't
or
go
even
to the,
her childhood?
Don't go to the Bible now. We are going here in the Quran.
No. You quote me.
My friend. Don't go. Okay. Who is Maryam? Maryam is the daughter of Amran, right?
Okay.
How Allah introduce Mary to you as a Muslim?
How Allah? You can read chapter 2, Al Imran, and Surah Maryam. There is a complete surah in her name.
Chapter. So
yeah,
this is.
And we believe that. We believe that she's a virgin, and we believe that she's the mother of Jesus, and we believe that she has been chosen, and we believe that she's from the best woman on earth, and we believe a lot of things that you don't believe it. I don't know. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. So Maryam in your religion, is introduced to us in which image, as a one, as what?
Virgin Mary.
I know it's. I'm not talking about what if she have sex or not.
And she's the mother of a prophet.
This is not the question. How the Quran introduced to you Mary? I mean, how Mary come into the Quran story? What is the story? Who is she? You told me that Mary is the daughter of Amran.
She's a normal woman.
She's a normal.
Been chosen.
Okay.
She has been chosen by Allah Azza wa Jalla.
Why she is chosen?
To be the mother and to be American. Let me complete. Okay, give me a chance.
Uh-huh.
She has been chosen by Allah Azza wa Jalla because she's very pure and she's so perfect. Mm. And Allah chose her to give birth for Sayyidina Isa, for Jesus, peace be upon him.
Mm.
And Allah has sent her Gabriel, Jibreel.
Mm.
And she had the miracle of the miracles that having a baby without a father, like Adam alayhi salam, he has been brought into this life without a father and without a mother. So if there's somebody should be called Allah or son of God, it'd be Adam, not Jesus, according to
All right. No, Adam is not, as Adam is not born, my friend. Adam is created from
mother.
Don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. In chapter 3, verse number 35, Mary, she made something in Arabic. We call it nadartu. What does that mean? Translate. Uh-huh. What does that mean?
You mean nether in English? I know what is nether in Arabic. It's not the proper word of English.
Is it someone he says, I will give it to you.
It's like for the sake of Allah. Yeah.
All right, that's
for
wonderful. Why Allah. This woman, she did that? Yeah. Why she did that?
What do you mean? Why did she
why,
that?
Why? You because know, usually, we usually, in, thought, yeah, usually yeah, in okay. Islam, people, they make a nether. If something happened, I will do this, correct?
Ah, yeah, I know what you mean. Okay, I can answer this question. This is good. This is very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Now, her nether is different from our nether. Her nether mm-hmm. is different because she's a mother of a prophet. Now, our nether, as
my friend, she is not a mother yet. She is not a mother yet. She is just a girl. She is a virgin.
She's pregnant. No. She's pregnant with Jesus.
Uh-huh.
So she's a mother.
My friend, this is not Mary. This is not Mary. My friend. We are not talking about Mary. We are talking about the mother of Mary. Mary is not the case. The mother of Mary, Imran wife. Okay. So now, she made a nether. She said, "I vow, if I vow, and the vow is whatever I give, I will get a pregnant with, I will give it to you." Why she made a vow?
Why? Now, I think now, and I don't want to give a false piece of information because I don't know, but I think she was a good believer and she was a very decent and honest woman in her society.
Mm.
And she was married to a very decent and honest man, who's Imran.
Mm-hmm.
And she was praying to the same Allah that Jacob and
Yusuf. I mean, are you going to continue until tomorrow? The answer is very simple. Tell me why she is making a vow that whoever I'm going to have is going to be yours.
Yeah, blessing it to sort of pray to bless this infant in her placenta or tummy, that please Allah give the blessing, your blessings to this baby who is in my placenta. So it's sort of a pray.
Mm.
Okay. So here, second question.
You did not answer me. Why she made a vow?
It's a pray.
Why?
Allah.
Why she made a vow? I'm not. This is not a prayer. She made a vow.
Decent,
she made a vow. She made a vow. If when I get a pregnant, I will do this.
You because my wife, she did the same for her four kids.
Mm-hmm.
She asked Allah to give the blessings for her babies.
Okay, let me show you. Okay, let me, my friend, show you. Open the screen in front of you. This is Tafsir Jamu al-Bayan fi Tafsir al-Quran al-Imam al-Tabari. Go down. You will see here it says that this woman, she prayed to God that if you made me pregnant, because she is old and she cannot get a pregnant, if you make me pregnant, I will vow. Hold on.
Okay.
فدعت الله أن يهب لها ولدا فحملت بمريم وهلك عمران. So now she have no husband no more. He died, her husband. She cannot have kids and she don't have kids. So she is praying to God, please God, let me have a son. So now God, he answered her call. But instead, hold on. You see, I'm reading your Islamic interpretation, not mine. So she prayed to God, and God responded, and he gave her a female. So this is the only daughter she have. And she is the only son she have, because she have no son. She asked Allah. She asked Allah for a son. Abdul, listen, listen, Abdul, listen, Abdul. Don't play games. It says yes. It says she is asking Allah to have a son. You know, but she said to him. But she said to him, the Quran confirmed that. She said, "You gave me an untha. You gave me a female, and the female is not what I asked for. You gave me because her husband died. She cannot have kids no more. She won't." And you know, let us say, listen. She asked for what? She asking Allah for a male. Why? Because she don't have any. She don't have any. And the hate in front of you, the interpretation. She fada'at Allah an yahiba laha waladan fa hamalat bi Maryam wa halaka umran. So she asked Allah, praying to Allah, please Allah, let me get pregnant with the male. So she get pregnant with Mary, and Umran die. So now they have no hope to get a new kids, and she has all already. Then when she know that she have in her, she already pregnant, she said to Allah, whoever you give me is going to be vote for you. Because this is the promise she made already, if he made her pregnant. And then when she get pregnant and she deliver a child, which is a girl. So how you want to say to me that Mary, she have a brother, his name is Aaron, and this is different Aaron, when your book saying that Mary, she have no brothers and no sisters?
Can I answer?
Yeah, please.
Okay, does it mention anything about the life? What's her name? Do you know her name, Mary's mother? It's Hannah, right?
Where do you get the, okay, where do you get the name from? Hannah. My friend, Hannah. Where do you get the name from? Where do you get the name from?
It's Hannah. It's Hannah, not Hannah.
Hannah is a name of, Hannah is the name of a guy, by the way. But anyway, where do you get the name from? Where do you get the name from?
Okay, now.
Where do you get the name from? I'm asking you.
From your old testimonies.
Okay, so how? So why Allah did not mention the name? Why Allah did not mention the name? And what is the name of the father of Mary?
Let me answer, Prince. Come on,
my friend. How come you are quoting for me from the old test, from the New Testament, the name of the father of Mary, the mother of Mary? But do you know who is the father of Mary?
I'm answering you. Can I answer now?
Go ahead.
Okay, now, now it doesn't say that Imran was dead when she got pregnant, because she cannot get pregnant without.
No, he died after she got pregnant, my friend. He died after she got pregnant.
Okay, no, because you mentioned earlier that she had no husband and he was dead.
My friend, no, this is not what I said. Are you on drugs? Listen carefully. Let me repeat. I don't like stupid talk. Okay, it's recorded, Abdul. Everything we are saying is recorded. People, they can play it again. Don't lie. Listen, Abdul, listen. You are Abdul. All of you are Abdul. Let me get you busted, my friend. Read with me carefully. Read with me carefully. Read with me carefully. Hold on. وكانت قد أمسك عن قد أمسك عنها الولد حتى أسنت. She was a woman. She could not give birth. Listen, shut up. I have no time for kids. أمسك عنها الولد حتى أسنت. وكانوا أهل بيتي بيت من الله جل ثناؤه بمكان. So she is a woman who get old and she don't have kids. She's old already. All right. And then while she was in the shade of a tree, she found a bird feeding his birds, baby birds. And then inside her stomach or her belly, a child moved, or she felt something. So she prayed to Allah to give her a baby male. فَحَمِلَتْ بِمَرْيَمْ. So she get pregnant with Maryam. وَهَلَكَ عُمْرَانْ. After she get pregnant, Umran die. That's what I say. So now this is confirmed to us that this woman, the mother of Mary, whoever her name is, because the Quran never gave anything, she was not pregnant all her life. She could not have a baby all her life. And she is praying to Allah to give her a baby boy, not a baby girl. And as you see in the front of you, it says that she cannot have children. She did not, and she is already asannat. She is old, and she don't have a boy. And now she prayed to Allah, and Allah, he answered her call, and he gave her a birth, but to a baby girl. And now that will get you busted about what your sheikh said to you, that Aaron is the brother of Mary, because we just confirmed to you that Aaron cannot be her brother from, sorry, you said this Aaron is different Aaron, not the brother of Moses. This is a brother of Mary, because as you see from your books, Mary, her mother, she gave birth only to one child, and that is her. How you answer that? The mic is yours.
What's that? Next question.
No, you don't answer anything. Answer. I just get you busted. No. Mary, she have no brothers, no sisters. Mary, she have no brothers, no sisters. The page in the front of you, the Quran in the front of you. Why you are lying?
No, I'm not lying. Who told you so? No,
I just give you the answer. Then give me the answer. How you Muslim believe that Mary, she have no brothers and she have no sisters? In the same time, you are saying to me that this Harun is the brother of Musa, but there's different Harun. You are the one who said that. Hold on, shut up. Guys, did this guy say that yes, this Aaron is a brother of Musa? Did he say that? But he said, oh, he is the brother of Musa. Sorry, he's the brother of Mary, but he is not the same guy, the brother of Musa. That's what he said. We heard him, right? It's recorded. Now we showed him his Islamic interpretation saying that Mary, mother, she vowed to God, she have a vow to God, that if he made her pregnant, because now she is old and she could not have children, if he can give her just a boy, and then God, he answered her call, and then he made her pregnant, and right away her husband died when she is pregnant, and this is the only child she have. So this guy, he did lie to us, saying that the sheikh said that Mary, she have a brother, his name is Aaron, and he is different from Aaron, the brother of Moses. The mic is yours. Let us laugh at you.
Come on. Next question. Yalla.
No, why this question? Why this question? We want to. You've been cooked. You've been cooked. Admit that you are lying. Admit that your Muslims are a bunch of liars. Why you lie to us saying that Mary, she have a brother, his name is Aaron, and this is not Aaron, the same as the brother of Moses. Why you lie? When your books and your scholars admit that Mary have no brothers, no sisters.
It doesn't say any previous history or facts about the history of
my friend. I just showed you the reference. Guys, did I show the reference? Yes or no? People in the chat. People in the chat, did I show the reference or not? Let me show the reference again. Hold on. Let me get you busted more. I'm going to give you the link. Hold on. This is Tafsir al-Tabari. Don't ask me a question. Wait. Tafsir al-Tabari. Let me give you the page number. You can ask me, no problem. But let me give you the page number. And I want you to confirm to me if what it says there is true. Is it true? Listen, my name, your name is Olga, and you are from Russia. Shut up. We can't talk at the same time. In page number 332, it says what I told you. Why you are lying? You Muslims, why you are lying? Why I cannot find a Muslim telling the truth? Hadith number, the book of At-Tabari, hadith number 6858. It's in the front of you. Apologize for lying and continue. Go ahead. Apologize for lying, please. Why you are lying to us? Oh, so we are done with this question? We got you busted with?
No. Do you have another question?
We have millions of questions.
Listen. Why don't we fix the timing? I want you to prepare your own homework good. Okay. I want you to be strong next time.
Uh-huh.
I want you to prepare a bullet of questions or list of questions. Mm-hmm. Send it to all of your viewers online. I'll be ready for that. You be ready for that. So we can discuss.
What's your name, my friend?
My name is Ahmed. I'm from Palestine.
Okay. No problem. My friend, you can call me anytime you wish. We are here at 4:30 p.m. All right, mostly. You can call me anytime as you wish.
Okay. What's the topic?
We don't have a topic. Our topic always is Islam.
You should be fair. You should be professional. About
no,
Islam.
This is why I'm my friend. Don't talk. Because I'm a professional, I challenge you with any topic. I don't need to prepare for a topic. You call me and talk to me. This is what professionals do. This is what people who have knowledge do. I don't need to get ready. You need to get ready because you are a kid.
I'm ready for you. Wallah, seriously. Come on.
Shall we continue or you want to go?
No. You tell me. My wife, she's cooking the food now. She's making,
I wish you a good appetite, my friend. I wish you a good appetite. I hope you will eat as much as you can.
Send you a dish. It's a very nice dish. It's okay. But I don't want you to mock the prophets. I don't want you to mock.
My friend, you Muslims, you mock your prophet, not me. You just mock your prophet. You just admitted that the Quran teaching lies. You just admitted that the Quran teaching lies. Take care. Call me when you are ready. I'm not going to waste my more time.